Hello guys, in this video we are going to discuss about the energy from the sun. So sun is actually a fireball which actually exhausts itself by using its own energy, and while it's doing that it is actually emitting a large amount of energy to its surface. So solar energy and the sun rays. The sun is a principal source of energy on the Earth's surface. It's like a powerhouse which generates and gives out energy in the form of light and heat. This energy, which is constantly emitted by the sun, is known as solar radiations. When a body gives out energy, it is called radiation. The energy produced by the sun comes to us in the form of sun rays. We can see and feel some aspects of this energy, such as like light and heat. However, we also receive many other forms of energy like ultraviolet rays, radio waves, X-rays from the sun, which can neither feel or see. The energy radiated by the sun is more or less constant with very little variation throughout the year and year after year. Then what causes the change in earth temperature? This is a question that we have to answer in this lesson. The solar radiation received on the earth surface is called insolation. The actual amount of solar energy received on the earth is only a small proportion of what reaches the earth's atmosphere. This is because 1/3 of solar energy is reflected back, like a mirror reflecting light, by the earth's atmosphere. Further, some portion of energy is shattered and scattered and absorbed in the higher reaches of the atmosphere. In fact, some of the harmful rays of sun, like UV rays, don't reach the ground, and this has made life possible on Earth. Some amount of the solar rays are also absorbed or reflected away by the clouds and smoke or dust in the atmosphere. You would have noticed that on cloudy days, it is not very hot. So as we know, we cannot see the UV rays, we cannot feel the radio waves, but one another way it actually comes from the sun, and it's emitting a large amount of light and as well as heat, and this is creating a reaction on Earth's surface as well, because it heats up the land and the water. And because of that, the wind changes directions, pressure from one place to another place differ. And this topic also relates to the butterfly effect, where an area can change drastically within a splits of seconds because of a small variation in that area. For example, if you are living in a AC room and all of a sudden you open the doors and outside there is hot temperature, the cool air starts to gush out and the hot air starts to come in as soon as possible because of the pressure variations. So in this example we will be discussing about how the temperature creates a various effects. So is the earth receiving a constant amount of energy from the sun? No, because this sunlight can be blocked by clouds. If there is a heavy rain in a certain area, on that day the temperature would be cool because the sun rays did not penetrate, because clouds are coming in between of them. And this sun energy is also used in solar energy, where people start to put the solar panels and this sun rays gradually hit the solar panels and so on so forth, and it goes to produce electricity. So even human beings thrived because of such kind of energy from the sun. And as a point of notion, previously we used to pray to the sun as if it brings a large amount of benefits to us, such as it gives us a photosynthesis. Plants use that energy as photosynthesis, and plants began to grow. And also, because of the sun heat, we also produce vitamin D in our body, and we need to expose ourselves more to the sun rays as well, because we were designed to do that. There are so many animals which actually survive because of the sun and its heat. Sometimes bats do not come out of the caves unless the sun goes down. That is a various topic, and this is a different topic as well. And this sun rays also emit a large amount of harmful rays as well, like ultraviolet rays and all that. Presently, because of global warming, the outermost layer of our atmosphere is actually decaying and causing the ultraviolet rays and harmful rays to penetrate and cause cancer. It causes skin cancer. So this is the amount of energy that the sun has, and the sun is so powerful that it's so heavy and it produces so much amount of heat that the closest to the sun is actually uninhabitable to human beings. The farthest away from the sun is so cold that it is inhabitable. And as closer to the sun we are, the hotter it gets. As farther from the sun we are, the colder it gets. And Earth is so lucky that we are in a certain position where the sun energy can actually be utilized by human beings, where water remains at a constant state, whereas in our Mars, the water remains in different states at a certain place. That is also a topic that you should refer. So that's how important the sun is. So in this video we have discussed two topics, that is radiation, where a body of anything gives out energy is known as radiation. There is solar radiation, there is ultraviolet rays which will be emitted, and also there are nuclear waste your body which radiates as well. There is radium which is radiating, and so on. And another topic we discussed in this video is the solar radiation received on the Earth surface is called insolation. So this is very easy and very close to remember, and this is a basic topic. In the coming chapter, we'll be discussing how Earth creates an atmosphere, how it changes a atmosphere, how the temperature changes because of the sun's position. So thank you guys, keep studying, keep on being curious.